So it's Francis with another 15-minute short little meditation for you guys. So we're going to start, so just get comfortable. If you want to sit down, if you want to lay down, it's up to you. So just get in a comfortable position. And from here, slowly begin to close your eyes. If you don't like closing your eyes, you can just find a soft spot to focus on. And let your eyes just relax. In fact, that's the first thing we're gonna do. So relax your breath. Let it be easy in and out. And from here, begin to take bigger breaths. You don't actually try to take the deepest breaths you can possibly take, but just think about the idea, big breath. And you'll start to find your breath just get deeper on its own. Now from here, starting at the tip top of your head, slowly begin just allowing yourself to relax. Give this time to yourself. Feel the wrinkles in your forehead relax, the crease in your brow. Feel your crow's feet around your temples. Feel it just release. Feel your jaw and your tongue relax. So often we talk about having a tight neck. Relax that. Feel those chips on your shoulders and feel them just begin to fall off, allowing your shoulders to relax. Feel your arms release. Feel that tension in your arms begin to just pour out from your fingertips. Feel your deep breath start to relax your chest. Imagine your stomach unraveling. So often when we are anxious, we feel it's described as having our stomach tied up in knots. So from here, try to imagine the opposite. Unraveling, loosening. Feel your back release. Feel it be at ease. Feel your hips open up. Feel the muscles of your thighs, your quads, your hamstrings. Feel those large muscle groups. Maybe tighten for a moment while you bring your attention to them, but then feel them relax. Feel your knees comfortable. Your shin, your calves. Feel your ankles relax. Your heels. The top of your foot, the bottom of your foot. Feeling that tension pour out of your toes. So taking a deep breath in as you breathe out. Tell yourself to relax. You've done a body scan. You know where you feel tightness in your body. You know where you feel tension. Direct your attention to those areas. And you'll be amazed at the power of your mind. Focus on that area. Take a breath in. And as you breathe out, send the idea of loosening and relaxing that area. See if you can force yourself to feel a little bit of relief. From here, begin to go inside of your body. Feel it relax. Because a lot of the times, when your body is relaxed, your mind is much more prone to relaxing itself. So we'll go deep inside and picture yourself from head to toe. Picture each strand of hair on your head, the color of your eyes, each individual fingernail. Picture yourself in your favorite outfit. Now from here, picture your favorite person. And I mean your real favorite person. Person that knows you in and out, the person that loves you. This could be your best friend, a family member, a colleague from work, your favorite person. Now, picture your favorite person waiting for you outside of your favorite restaurant. You walk up to meet them and they want to bring you inside. You trust them. You allow them to guide you. And it is a surprise party in your honor. You are surrounded by smiling faces. Everything is going swimmingly. Your favorite food is served. Your favorite music is playing. You are so happy and grateful for all the effort that has been put forth for you. Toward the end of the day, the dinner, your friend goes to the front of the restaurant and does a little tinkling on his glass, calling everyone's attention. Your favorite person has everyone's attention. And he begins a toast about you. About what he appreciates, he or she or they appreciate about you. I'm going to give you a few moments and I want you to listen to their toast. Remember, this person knows you. They appreciate you. They know you. They know your intricacies, your quirks. They can see beyond the mask that you wear in front of other people. What does this person see? And why are they grateful to be your favorite person? What do they say about you? Take a moment. And really listen to this toast about you. Now, from here, you can pause the video. If you want to take a moment and write down the bullet points, the highlights of the toast, that's an option. Or if you can just remember it, also another option. Reflect on what was said. And then think, if you had to write even just a short paragraph of what makes you, you, what makes you amazing, what makes you wonderful, what would you write? Would it be the same as what your favorite person said about you? So often there's a disconnect and we're not able to be honest with ourselves. But somehow, adding in that third person factor, looking at us, looking at ourselves objectively, we're able to do it. Now, why is there that disconnect? What is holding you back from saying those wonderful things about yourself? You just said it about yourself. Can you repeat your favorite person's toast about you to yourself? And when you're feeling down, when you're feeling in the negative, when you're feeling down about yourself, remember this exercise and maybe do it for yourself again. And look at that silver lining on that cloud, knowing that the rain doesn't last. And know deep down inside, if you're being honest with yourself all the time, maybe you think these positive affirmations to yourself all the time, which is wonderful. For a lot of us, it's not an accessible trait. And sometimes it helps to have that third party objective stance, even though it's not quite a third party, to help us feel good about ourselves and know that these good things that you just said, they're not arbitrary. If I were to tell you you are strong, maybe you don't care. I said you're smart, you're like, I know, I don't care. But right now, I'd wager a guess that during your favorite person's little speech about you, they said exactly what you needed to hear. So remember that and keep it to heart. And if you ever need a reminder, you can always do this little exercise. And that is my meditation for this week for you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. I will see you next week. Once more, my name is Francis. Thanks for joining us on UNLV's Rebel Rec YouTube page. Have a good day, evening. I don't know. Bye, guys.